Will everyone please stand for the bride?
To be young and in love in New York City. Do not know who I am, but still know that I'm good long as you're here with me. To be drunk and in love in New York City. Midnight into morning coffee, burning through the hours talking. Yeah. I like me better when I'm with you. I like me better when I'm with you. I knew from the first time, I stayed for a long time. Cause I like me better when, I like me better when I'm with you.
All right, hello everyone. I know it's very hot out, so we're gonna keep this as short as possible, even though I know we've already waited 2 years for this. I think it is.
Yeah, mic check.
Can I get a mic check, please? Mic check. I have to make the same joke over again. Sorry. Is it working? Is it better? No?
You press the button?
Yes, it's green.
Yeah, it is green.
Hello, hello, checking. Checking the mic. It's gonna be good.
What do you got for a stand-up?
Yeah, I did not plan any more jokes than what I have. Okay. Hello, hello. Better? No, I know. It's not better. But hello? Hello? Oh, better? No, I'm making that up. Okay. Hello? Can everyone know? Hello, hello, hello. I'm gonna turn it off and on.
Okay. You did have it for a second.
I did. Hello? Hello, hello? Nothing. It's
the
okay.
Heat.
It's maybe the hot, you know?
Yeah.
Everything's melting.
Yeah.
Except for Sarah's makeup. It's great. Hello, hello, hello. Testing. Testing the mic. We tested it earlier, I promise. Hello? Hello, 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 hello. Hear the sound too much. Hello? No? Testing? Yeah. I think she'll.
Oh, here we go! Yeah!
That's great. All right. We'll do this. Oh, no. Hello? Up and down. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm not going to move. Okay. Hi everyone again. I know it's hot outside, so we're gonna keep this super short, even though I know we've all waited over 2 years for this, the marriage celebration of Mark and Sarah. And although there were some other events here and there, including a special Lexington celebration with Sarah's grandma, I know they are especially grateful to finally have you all here today, traveling from places near and far, as far as Canada and even Connecticut, which I know was not the initial plan when you chose this venue. And speaking on behalf of everyone here, we are so happy to be celebrating with you both. We've been so lucky to have you in our lives, and I'm particularly grateful you chose me to officiate your ceremony. I met Sarah on a friendship blind date around 8 years ago, just across the river in New York City. She had just transferred to the city, and we connected through mutual friends from work. Over time, I have been lucky enough to experience all the wonderful things about Sarah that I know all of you also know. Her hospitality, her caring heart, her hard work, and her homemade hummus, to name a few. Crazy to think that those couple of drinks at the ship has turned into a lifelong friendship that means so much to me and that now has expanded to include someone who I now also consider a friend, Mark. Forgive me, Mark, but I cannot remember the first time we met, but I do remember as I got to know you, a couple things came to mind. Number one, wow, this guy has a lot of close friends that he has kept in touch with for decades, like truly a lot. Number two, he and his family are adorably close and he's a doting uncle. Number three, how have I not seen Santa with muscles that Mark introduced me to? And finally, the reason we are all here, he is a wonderful partner to Sarah. I recently read this definition of love. Love is not a feeling. It is an overmastering passion to help, to deliver and comfort and strengthen and give joy to others. I immediately wrote next to this, this is how Sarah and Mark love. This is the type of love you've shown me, your friends, your family, and the type of love you continuously have for one another. And that will keep your marriage going strong for years to come. So with that, before you guys give your vows, Sarah's brother Hassan would like to say a few words.
Keep it very, very few, because yes. I can see people are fanning themselves even faster and faster.
Yeah.
What's that?
Closer.
Yes. There you go.
All right. Yeah. So we'll keep this super short. I can see people fanning themselves even faster. Even closer, chips. Seems unsanitary.
Swallow.
Sorry.
Swallow them like.
You know, you're gonna hear about Sarah and Mark and how amazing they are, and I had so many stories I actually wanted to share with you all, but I'll actually keep it to how I found out about this. I think it was probably after the second or third date, Sarah actually called me and said, I met this guy. She would never do that. So right off the bat, the fact that she's telling me about someone she's met is already going, wow, this must be interesting, something enough that she would want to tell me about it. And she started talking about him. The first date, it was short, 3-4 hours, because she had to go to work the next day. The next date, suddenly they're out there for 7-8 hours. And the rest of it, I don't quite remember what she said, because she told me Mark's really into fly fishing, like myself, and that he's actually really good at it. And from that point, I don't remember anything really else about Mark, except that he really likes fly fishing and he's good at it.
Right off the bat.
So I thought to myself, you know what, he's obviously, he's determined, pays attention to detail, and dedicated. And I thought to myself, geez, that's, you know, what a great place to start. To the point that when my mother asked me about him 2 months later, I think it took you 2 months before you told Mom and Dad, she comes up to me and says, because she knew she told me more about him, and she's like, well, what do you know about him? I'm like, he fly fishes. That's all I really need to know. So, and that's really all I did need to know, because I trust my sister's judgment from day one, from when she was a little girl, so smart, so determined, and with a heart and kindness. I'm sorry, I'll stop. To match. There's so many. The first paycheck, for example, that you ever got from your job, you remember what you did? You spent it on me, the entire thing, to buy me that little waterproof digital camera that I could take fishing with me. That's the first thing you wanted to spend your money on. And it goes on, and it goes on. And to find someone like yourself in a partner like Mark, I mean, for us as a family, this celebration started years ago. And yeah, it just gets better and better with every day that goes by. It's just a dream come true considering where we once were as a family. So many years ago in Iran, where our parents had a good life and they had to come back. I'd had to leave it all behind. They were forced to leave it and start from scratch. And it was a very tumultuous time until Sarah was born, and then the whole world lit up. And then here we are today, here with all of you, here in this city with this view. It's unbelievable. And I'd like to thank you all once again for being here to share this amazing occasion for us. It's a celebration not of just today, but of the journey that they started, like I said, long ago. For me, it starts back from 2017 when you guys first met. Did I get that right? Was it 2017?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Good. Anyway, with that, folks, I'll stop it there. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thank you. Even though it's technically ceremony number 3, Sarah and Mark have saved sharing of their vows for this moment and would now like to share with you all the promises they have written for each other, starting with Sarah.
I'm gonna keep it together, I promise.
All right.
You got it. Sorry. All right. Finally made it after so many years. I can't believe we're finally here. I was so lucky to meet you across the Hudson here 5 years ago. what were the chances that we would have stayed together with our crazy schedules back then? You had your Cape Cod trip, your Maine trip. I was traveling for work every single week. So let's go to Tanzania for a few weeks on top of all that. But I knew from the beginning you were the bum, and I couldn't believe it. You are the love of my life. I could have never asked for a better partner to build a life with, to explore the world with, to one day have a family with. You pushed me to pursue even greater achievements than I could have ever imagined doing on my own. You bring out the best in me every single day, and I'm so grateful for that. Even as our lives literally took a 180 over the last couple years, you were more supportive than I could have ever imagined. We went through 10 months of drawn out renovations, 5 of those with my dad, testing all of our limits, but we survived, we learned a lot, and we made our house our home. You are the sweetest, most selfless soul I have ever met. You are grounded, you are my rock, and I vow to be the same for you. I promise to snowboard with you until our knees and joints tell us not to. I promise to fit fly fishing into every trip we can together. And I promise to be by your side through all of the ups and downs and to grow old with you. I'm so excited to grow old with you. You're my best friend. I love you so much.
Thank you.
All right. Woo! Yes.
Ah. Ah. All right. All righty. So mine starts off a little differently. 17 years ago. I walked down a different aisle with this guy, alongside half of the other guys you see up here with me today, as we graduated from the 2005 class of Fairlawn High School. And if someone would have told me that at that time, in June of 2005, that in 17 years, almost to the very date, I'd be partaking in my third wedding ceremony with the same woman, a second-generation Iranian, born in Vancouver, Canada, daughter to heroic parents, sister to a selfless brother who just so happens to be an avid fly fisherman, at a two-time global pandemic-caused-postponed Persian-American wedding, overshadowed by Britney Spears, taking place under threat of war, hyperinflation, and monkeypox, after 3 moves, 6 total combined job changes, 1 home purchase and renovation, within 5 short years of knowing one another, all because I commented on how pretty her eyes were in a picture of herself while perusing a dating site on a handheld computer that combined my Razer phone with my iPod and my AOL account. Well, in reality, I would have simply thanked you for that interesting, unique Mad Lib, thought nothing else of that unimaginable story, and moved on with my life at that time as an unaware wannabe cast member of the yet-to-be-created hit TV show Jersey Shore. And while none of that has anything to do with what I'm supposed to be saying right now, it is a reminder of the incredible luck I once possessed. Every morning I wake up to you and feel like the luckiest man in the world. But deep down, the truth is, I used up every last ounce of luck I had on this planet. The minute... God, it's like 8 more paragraphs ago. The minute you agreed to meet me for a drink on a late Sunday night in the spring of 2017. But that's okay, I don't have any use for luck anymore when I already have you. But yes, for those wondering, you can blame me and my drained luck for the reason why I've had to wait 908 days from the day you said yes to stand here before you now in 110-degree heat. But in reality, I've waited much longer, 35 years to be exact, and would gladly wait another 35 if it meant having you by my side. Those who truly know me know that I am not great at making decisions. I tend to hem and haw and second-guess the best decisions that life throws my way. Though when it came time to make arguably the biggest decision of my life, choosing the person I would spend the rest of my life with, there was no second guessing. It was always you. You were my much better half. You undoubtedly make me a better person in every facet of life, and I don't think I could find anyone who would disagree. Frankly, I too am pumped to grow old with you, which is a funny thing to feel, but it's 100% true in this moment, since no longer does growing older seem as ominous as it once was, because my future with you is undeniably more promising than anything I could have once imagined or previously experienced. Truthfully, I've wasted everyone's time here so far, but But that's only because I truly don't know what I can promise someone who has given me far more than what I can ever offer in return. In fact, there aren't enough words in the English language to string together vows worthy of your continued attention. And mon cami farsi baladam, but I can only assume I'd have the same trouble searching for the right words to say in Farsi. But nevertheless, this is what I'm up here to do, so here's my best attempt. You make me happier than anyone could possibly know, and seeing you laugh, seeing you smile is second to none. And I promise to be the number one contributor to that smile from now till the end of time. Your determination, drive, diligence, and work ethic are impossible to keep up with. But you inspire me every day, and there's no limit to what you will accomplish. My promises can only fall short here, but at the very least, I vow to be the foundation upon which you can build, your biggest cheerleader, your number one listener, and when possible, can provide some advice. You make me a better man, a better son, a better brother, a better uncle, a better friend. Behind everything I do now, there's a piece of you. And I promise to continually better myself to perhaps someday be the person you truly deserve. All right, it's almost over. The sacrifices and choices your family has made for you, capitalizing in the woman you've become today, will never cease to amaze me. And I think we can all agree that if I can promise to be half as brave, resilient, and selfless as your parents and family were for you, for our own family, we'd be in pretty good shape. 17 years ago, I could never have predicted any of this. And even to this day, I'll never understand why a stunningly beautiful and intelligent Iranian-Canadian chose to give a suburban kid from New Jersey who looks like the cumulative average of everyone who attends a local Proud Boy rally a shot. But even though none of this makes sense to me, I've come to understand that at some point, you just gotta learn to when to shut up and accept that Sarah is right. So with that, Sarah, that's your good time.
Thank you both. Sarah and Mark have already exchanged rings as a symbol of their love and commitment, but they wanted to re-exchange those rings in front of all of you today. Sarah and Mark, as you place this ring on their finger, please repeat after me. I will start with you, Mark.
Okay.
With this ring. I pledge you my love. Now and forever.
Now and forever.
And Sarah.
With this ring.
I pledge you my love. Now and forever.
Now and forever.
It is now my honor to pronounce you one last time, husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
Let's burn the roof, and then we'll do it again. that tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.
Put those hands together for Corey and Casey. Hey.
Let's live it up.
Let's live it up.
I got my money. Hey. Let's spin it up.
Let's spin it up.
Go out and smash it.
Smash it.
Like on my car.
Like on my car.
Jump out that song.
Next up, we have Alex and Sarah. All right, at this time, you need to get up out of your seats. Let all of New York City hear you. Please welcome for the third time, one last time, Sarah and Mark Quintavelle. Perfect song. Oh, this is going to be a good group. They're going to stay on the floor for their first dance as husband and wife.
Days when the rains came down in the hollow, playing a new game, laughing and running, hey, skipping and jumping in the misty morning fog with our hearts thumping, and you, my brown-eyed girl, you, my brown-eyed girl, whatever happened to Tuesday so slow, going down the old mine with a transistor radio. Standing in the sunlight laughing, hiding behind a rainbow's wall, slipping and sliding all along the waterfall with you, my brown-eyed girl, you, my brown-eyed girl. Do you remember when we used to sing sha-la-la-la?
Come on, sing along with them.
La-la-la-la-la-la, ta-da. Just like that. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-
And at this time, they're going to join their parents on the floor for their song.
For all the wrongs that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you, I'll be forever thankful, baby. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall.
Right, the bride and groom would like to have everyone join them on the floor for this remainder of this song.
You gave me wings, you made me fly. You touched my hand, I could touch the sky. I lost my faith, you gave it back to me. You said no star was out of reach. You stood by. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We're not going to be dying in the heat this time. We're just going to be interrupting your lovely meal. So, hi everyone. Thank you for making it to this special day, nearly 3 years in anticipation and in planning. We'll tell everybody that we were planning it for 3 years. My name is Malia. I'm one of the maids of honors tonight, and what an honor it is to be with all of you and with Sarah and Mark. Thank you so much. I'm going to try to get through the speech without shedding a single tear. So Sarah and I met in Toronto, Toronto for all the Toronto people without the second T, while doing our masters. Someone actually thought we were smart enough to get a second degree, and which we did. We were only 21 years old. That was a really long time ago. Sorry to date us. More than 10 years ago. It seems like ages ago now, doesn't it? We spent a lot of our time together. I mean, inseparable, with the exception of the times that Sarah was traveling for work. I'm gonna just... Whew. All of the nights that we spent together, we barely survived. I just want you to know, there were a lot of pizzas eaten at late at night, a lot. We worked really hard, we partied really hard. We laughed really hard and we cried really hard. We had the time of our lives. Throughout all of this time, I knew I could rely on Sarah. She's a trusted advisor, not just to me, but to all of you. She's a recipe sharer. If you haven't tried her gin sangria, it is a must try. She's a great friend and confidant. She moved to New York City all on her own and took it by storm. She's powerful. She can accomplish anything she desires. She still finds time to stay totally attuned to your life and asks how you're doing. And she's so kind. I'm gonna kill the punchline, but who knew all of this could come in a 4'1" package, right? You might wonder how she's managed to keep it all together. You think I'm gonna talk about Mark, but we're not there yet. This is where I'm going to talk about the people who have shaped this wonderful human being. I'm going to talk about Sarah's parents and you too, Ehsan, Sarah's brother. The first time I stayed with Sarah's parents, they welcomed me with open arms and even gave me my own bedroom. I felt like I was one of their own children. One of the things that I will never forget when I stayed there was the overwhelming amount of food that was available to me, hand-prepared for my arrival. I think I gained a few pounds before leaving back to Toronto. Similarly, Sarah is an excellent host and always has something cooking, literally. When Sarah was little, she would see these really unique dishes that she wanted to try and she was super curious about. So she'd go to her parents and she'd insist that she wanted to try these out. Just like anything else that she wants to accomplish, she explained to them what she needed and wanted to replicate these dishes. So Sarah's parents would go out, they would get her the ingredients, they would push a little stool up to the stove, and then Sarah would put all these ingredients together. And voila, a perfect dinner from an 8-year-old. I'm sure you know that Mark gets the same level of cuisine at home. Mark, How do you keep up all the weight off? Can we just say this is probably the fittest wedding couple in the history of all time? Just FYI, as a side note, Sarah went for a morning run this morning while we were all getting ready. That's right. All right, now on to Mark. Meeting Mark for the first time in their apartment just down the street from here, we drove together to the infamous ski trip. the entire drive, Mark was patient, he was kind, and he didn't get a single word in while me and Sarah caught up. I thought to myself, man, he's the one. Not for me, for Sarah. For Sarah. Mark, thank you so much for continuing to support Sarah's curiosity, her inquisitiveness, and her goals. Sarah always tells me, he's gotta treat you like a queen. And rest assured, Mark knows what he's doing, because queen indeed she is. Mark, I hope you're getting at least the prince treatment in return. Getting close, Jig. Mark, you are so good. You radiate good. You're so kind. Thank you for welcoming us all into your life, like we're your family. Sarah and Mark's generosity and kindness is magnified because they're together. They bring out the best in each other. Sitting across from us today is a couple that couldn't be more in love. Thank you both for letting us be part of your special day. Cheers to you.
I don't know if I can top that off, Malia. That was an amazing speech. Hi, everyone. How's everyone's night going so far? Woo! For those of you who don't know me, my name is Nagar, and I'm the other maid of honor for Sarah. I'm so happy to be here with everyone. So now to tell you a little bit about how I know this lovely bride. So Sarah and I grew up together as childhood friends. Our parents actually met before we were actually born. So they met in Greece in the 80s, if I'm not mistaken, and then they immigrated to Canada in the 90s, and they remained very close family friends. So obviously Sarah and I grew up spending a lot of time together through the connection of our families, but the continuation of our friendship remained because of the love we have for each other. There's so many amazing memories I've shared with this beautiful girl. I don't even know where to start. So whether it was playing with our Beanie Babies or Polly Pockets or learning to cook together, you remember those Easy Bake ovens we used to have? Yeah. We used to do that all the time together. We used to trade our toys all the time. We'd have like annual trades, and she was really particular on that. She'd be like, no trade backs allowed. Like once you trade, that's it, it's a done deal. And then we used to go to Alice Lake with her family annually. And then we also used to camp in her backyard. We did everything together. Oh, stuck. Oopsies. So as we got older, we continued making memories together. So me and Sarah went to different universities. Sarah went to UBC, I went to SFU. Hers had the better parties, so I'd always go to UBC just so I can party with her. But she was definitely more responsible than me. Even when we drink, she'd make healthy cocktail smoothies. They tasted good though. One of Sarah's most admirable qualities is how selfless and kind-hearted she is. I always feel safe when she's there. I've always looked up to you, Sarah. Thank you for being my sister, my friend, and my role model. You found a good catch, Sarah. Catch? I can see the abundance of love between the two of you. Mark, it's nice to see how much you adore Sarah. I can see it. It's so genuine, it's so real, and you make her so happy. You guys are definitely a power couple. Hashtag goals. wishing you both a lifetime of love and happiness. Now let's raise our glasses and toast. Can I grab this? Yeah? Okay. To the bride and groom.
Hello, everybody? Okay. Yeah, I gotta wrap now. Hello, everyone, and welcome to what is sure to be the most captivating and talked about 36 minutes of this wedding. My name is Elliot Strange, and I have the honor of being the one and only co-best man on this momentous occasion. What's that I hear? A question from the audience? What is this schlub, this bozo, doing up here in front of you all? Well, that's a pretty good question, but it's one with a pretty good answer as well. I have had the pleasure of knowing Mark since he was about 7 years old. I've also known Mark and Sarah since the early days of their relationship, and I even attended both their first and now third weddings, and there are not many people that are able to say all of those things. Since those young buck years with Mark, we have seen and done it all together. Too much, in fact, to fit in what should be a succinct speech, so I'll give you a... Too much, in fact, to fit in what should be a succinct speech, so I'll give you a brief overview. We made our onstage debut soon after meeting in summer camp at the age of 7 years old, and there's video proof. In elementary school, we played a ton of koosh tag, and we hunted scary ghosts in our friend's basement. I don't really remember much of middle school, and that's probably the best, probably for the best, because those were some awkward years, but I do remember hunting scary ghosts near the train tracks. In high school, we battled it out for who would be first trombone, even though neither of us ever practiced our instrument. In college, we won many beer pong tournaments, and we won many since. After college, we moved in together for a year and were roommates, and we co-authored one of the most influential blogs of our time, which during its run gathered over 12 views. And then finally, we sort of, kind of grew up, although we still hunt scary ghosts virtually at a professional level, which is pretty impressive. No, nobody over here. No, it's like that's a four people know this. Anyway, moving on. Through all those experiences, I've learned that Mark is the kind of guy that always has his friends' backs. He's very loyal, and he protects the ones that he loves, and he volunteers his time for his friends, his family, and his community. Those are all great things to have in a friend. But as I was writing this speech, I started to think, what is the one thing that makes me and Mark, and I guess Dima, the other co-best man, such great friends? Is it our shared love of the greatest musical group of all time, and the most talented musical group of all time, which everybody here knows is The Offspring? It might have something to do with it. Is it our shared passion for hurtling ourselves down hills or mountains, whether it be on skis, snowboards, or ski blades over the years? It might have a smidgen of relevance. But after days, weeks, and months of contemplation, introspection, reflection, and other words that kind of mean the same thing, I came to a conclusion, and I think it's the right one. The three of us are such great friends because we share the uncanny ability to convince women that are way out of our league to marry us. And that brings us to Sarah. She's kind, she's fun, she's funny, she's successful, and she makes a beautiful bride. But those are all things that people here already know or could probably learn soon after meeting her. When you really get to know Sarah, you find that she is an incredible host who makes everybody feel welcome in her home. She's an amazing cook that will tailor one dish 16 different ways just to accommodate all of her friends' annoying allergies. But the most important thing to know about Sarah, which was previously mentioned, but many here might not know about, is that she makes the most incredible mixed drinks on the planet. I won't bore you with the stories that I have, the many stories that I have after imbibing one or several of her clever concoctions, but that's mostly because I can't remember any of them. But seriously, Sarah is awesome, and I've never seen Mark as happy or as comfortable as he is with anybody but her. I think we can all agree that these two make an amazing couple. They travel the world together with a sense of adventure and curiosity. I'm losing it. they bring out the best in one another, and they support each other through challenges and opportunities when they arise. As a guy who has been married for almost 5 years now, you might think that I have some advice for you two. For other couples, I might, but for you two, all I have is this. Just keep doing what you're doing, because you two are crushing it. Yeah. And that's pretty much it. So cheers to Mark and Sarah, and what is sure to be a life filled with happiness.
Hello, everyone. My name is Dimitri, and I am Mark's other half of his best man. Mark, Sarah, please open your gifts. Now, what you guys have been hearing about Mark's fly fishing excursions, how he's a great fly fisherman, and these gifts will... please hold them up for the audience. Sarah's taking a little bit of time. Please hold them up for everyone to see. These are schoolie striped bass. And these bass represent the typical size fish that Mark catches on a given outing. But also, these striped bass represent you guys. And I'll tell you why. Because schoolies stick together. They travel great distances together. They grow together, they eat together, and they have little fish babies together when they're ready. But you guys can have just regular babies, doesn't need to be fish babies. Please exchange fish and place your hands upon each other's basses as I give you a couple of words of wisdom for your marriage. Sarah, when Mark talks about his fly fishing excursions, pretend to listen and be very interested. For your information, any striped bass over 30 inches or any trout over 20 deserves an open-eyed stare and a wow. Sarah, consider his passion for fly fishing a gift to you. It gives you the gift of missing him on those early weekend mornings until he returns home to bore you of stories of the one that got away. Mark, you've done your preparations. You've tied a strong knot here, and you've got yourself a keeper. No catch and release here, my friend. Sarah, if you ever let Mark plan a trip, you can assume it's gonna be near a lake, river, bay, ocean, stream, creek, or puddle, and fishing will transpire. Sarah, you always know the right bait to offer your fishermen after a fishing outing. Plethora of charcuterie, abundance of cheeses, an assortment of hummuses, hummi, whatever. Just a few of the presentations that you have at the end of your line that Mark and I are thankful for. Keep it up. Sarah, like a fly tire combines the perfect materials for the perfect fly, you combine ingredients for the perfect mixed drink. It has coined the name Sarah Drink and intoxicates even the most seasoned drinkers and is impossible to say no to. It's a theme around the wedding. Everyone knows about your cocktails. You just need to not make them as strong when Mark and I gotta get up at 5 a.m. to go fishing, because the hangover's not good. Mark, when you're driving, when you're driving and you pass a body of water, make sure Sarah holds on to the steering wheel, because I know you're gonna be looking left and right for bass crushing bait or trout sipping flies. But actually, the Tesla drives itself, so you guys should be good on that one. Sarah, since Mark is a catch and release kind of guy, you never have to worry about fish guts in the sink or in the trash. You got yourself a keeper as well. Sarah, one final point. If you ever come upon striped bass at a restaurant, get up and leave before Mark sees it. We need to keep his blood pressure in check. And to both of you, stand beside each other, but not on Mark's casting side. Know that in life there will be high tides, there will be low tides. There will be days when you seem to be swimming against the current. There will be tangles that seem impossible to reverse. But go to the bank, sit down, take a deep breath, be patient, and when that tangle unweaves, get back out there on the river of life. I love you guys and wish you nothing but the best.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
So I'm going to start in Farsi this time. Salam hamegi. خیلی خوش آمدین. خیلی خوشحالم که همه تون تونستین اینجا بیاین واسه این جشن. اینجور جشنا تو زندگیمون کم هست. اصلا اتفاق نمیفته. اینجا آدم از همه جای آمریکا و کانادا با هم جمع شیم. بعد از همین سالها. You know what happened last few years. So, ما خیلی خوشحالیم همتون اینجا اومدین. خیلی تشکر میکنیم که اینجا اومدین. فقط خوش بگذره. امشب هنوز اولشه. هنوز رقص و همه چی مونده. خیلی خوشحالیم اینجا این. تشکر میکنیم. مرسی. So just a quick thank you to everyone here. We know you all have traveled so long and far to come here. A lot of folks are in Vancouver, Boston, Arizona, DC. I'm missing a whole bunch. I think Cyprus, Toronto, there's a whole bunch. Thank you, everyone. This is really, honestly, a destination wedding in New York, which is very close to where we live. So hope you're all enjoying visiting here. It means the world to us that you guys all made it. This wouldn't happen without everyone taking the time. 2 years at the Save the Dates, making it here. Thank you. Quick thank you to our vendors too. You all stood by us from the beginning. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. And the night is just beginning. I hope you're all ready for the best dance mix. I'm hyping this up real hot in a minute. We love you. Thank you so much for being here.
Oh, I got it now. I'm not going to add. I'm not going to spend too much time. The only thing I'll add real quick, you know, behind the scenes, and I've said this before, behind the scenes, I mean, this has been 900 days in the making, right? And a lot of things have happened, COVID, we moved to Connecticut, renovations, all that stuff. And as you can imagine, there were plenty of times that we sat here and said, why are we doing this? You know, what are we doing this for? You know, the time, the effort, the money to put on this event. We've already been married for 2.5 years and we celebrate in Kentucky and this and that. And the thing that we kept on coming back to was really, everyone here, it was all for all of you. At some point down the line, we said, you know, this celebration wasn't just about us. It was really about getting this group of people in the room under one roof at one time, knowing that this probably won't ever happen again, to be honest. Families are very spread out. And it's been 2 years of just dealing with whatever you had to deal with over the last 2 years. And I'm hoping that tonight's a stepping stone back to somewhat normalcy, somewhat normal cadences of seeing family members and seeing friends and just having a good time. So, you know, with that, let's just party like it's 2019 and, you know, have a good night.
چقدر اطفال میریزی چه پر روب با چه ریزی چقدر اطفال میریزی چه پر روب با چه ریزی که خوش کرده من آی بانو آی بانو آی بانو 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 بانو
زانو غوغام با گل از این ناز و کرشمه دلم شد چشمه چشمه دلم شد چشمه چشمه وای 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 ناز و بنو چه گل من دختر قنچه گل من کوچه به کوچه گل من نازی و نازی ناز گل من نازنین دلبر خوشگل من غوغام با گل از این ناز و کرشمه دلم شد چشمه چشمه دلم شد چشمه چشمه وای 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 وای
Feel, but you know ain't for you. گلشگرش شاهزاده ها دور و برش واسه پسر کوچیکترش آیا بدم آیا ندم آیا بدم آیا ندم کسی میدم که تک باشه ملک باشه و ملک باشه به کسی میدم که تک باشه ملک باشه و ملک باشه
شاه شهر ما بیاد با
سر برو بیاد بیاد با گنج هدیه ها بیاد آیا بدم آیا ندم آیا بدم آیا ندم کسی میدم که کس باشه یه هر تنش افس باشه کسی میدم که کس باشه یه هر تنش افس باشه They can't, they won't, they never will stop the party. Stop the party, party, party. They can't, they won't, they never will stop the party.
Make some noise if you're having a good time.
I say y'all having a good time.
Nobody. امشب تموم عاشقا با ما میخونن یک صدا میگن تو ای عاشق ترین عروس دنیا دلم و بردارم بپر کوچه به کوچه شهر نشن بگو که نظر چشمات ای عروس دل بر یه جفت چشم سیاه و یه حلقه تلانی یه فرشه یاس و الواس و دلی که شد پدانی آره من مسته مستم با این عهدی که بستم پیش اون آینه چشمات وای نپرس از من کی هستم ای عروس مهتا ای مستی مینا اون شب بازد تو بوسه تو ماد و دریا حالا که با تو هستم دنیا رو میپرستم نگی که یه وقت نگفتم عاشقت هستم تا زنده هستم شب چارده امشب پیش تو کمیاره اون سر نوشت زیبا ببین چه گرده با ما هم بگی بگی ماشالله مبارک ایشالله ای عروس مهتا ای مستی میرم امشب بازد تا بوسه تو ماد و دریا حالا که با تو هستم زنده هستم
ای جونم قدمات رو چشم بیا با مهمونم شد گرمی خونم شو ببین پریشون دلم بیا آرومم کن ای جونم خوابت رتنت ببیچه تو خونم تو که نیستی سرگردون دیوونم ای جونم بیا که داغونم ای جونم عمرم نفسم اشتم توی همه کسم و این که چه خوشحالم تو رو دارم ای جونم ای جونم دلیل بودنم عشقت مثل خون تو تنم آیی که چه خوشحالم تو رو دارم ای جونم پر بارونم بیا جونم بیا که قدر بودن تو میدونم میدونی اگه بگی که میمونی منو به هرچی میخوام میرسونی تا که جونی بیا بگو که میمونی جونم عمرم نفسم اشتم کسم و این که چه خوشحالم تو رو دارم ای جونم ای جونم دلیل بودنم عشقت مثل خون تو تنم و این که چه خوشحالم تو رو دارم ای جونم
همونی که همیشه میمونی
fit you hot. They like me, I want them to love me like they love pop. But holla in New York, you shout to tell you I'm loco. When the plan is to put the rap game in the choke. Oh, I'm full of focus, man. My money on my mind, got a meal out the deal and I'm still in the grind. I show you sexy, filling my stash, filling my flow. A girl from Woody, they buy and they ready to go. I'm getting low, bottle full of bug. Mama, I got what you need, you need to fill the buzz. I'm in the habit of sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, be in the getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bug. Mama, I got what you need, you need to fill the buzz. I'm in the habit of sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, be in the getting rough. Go shawty, it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. Go shawty, it's your birthday.
When I do that soldier boy, I lean to the left, then crank that thing now.
You!
I'm jocking on you,
I'm jocking on you.
And if we get the fight, then I'm counting on you. You catch me at your local party, yes, I crank it every day. Haters getting mad, cause I got me so baby, mate.
Soldier boy, I'm in it. Why me crank it, why me roll? Why me crank that soldier boy, that Superman?
Dream.
دستم هانسیست هانسیه بدونم سنی چون یادم سنی چون گیتری رو یادم بسن گیرم که یادم بسن هانسیست هانسیه بدونم سنی چون یادم سنی چون
Sarah and Mark's generosity and kindness is magnified because they're together. They bring out the best in each other. Sitting across from us today is a couple that couldn't be more in love. Thank you both for letting us be part of your special day. Cheers to you.
And in love in New York City. Do not know who I am, but still know that I'm good long as you're here with me. To be drunk and in love in New York City. Do not know who I am, but still know that I'm good long as you're here with me. To be drunk and in love in New York City. And not into morning coffee, burning through the hours talking. I like me better when I'm with you. I like me better when I'm with you. I knew from the first time I stayed for a long time. Cause I like me better when I like me better when I'm with you. Where the room, yeah, got no ceiling. If we lay that the day just passes by, I might get to too much talking. I might have to tell you something. Damn. I like me better when I'm with you. I like me better when I'm with you. I knew from the first time I stayed for a long time. Cause I like me better when I like me better when I'm with you. Where the room, yeah, got no ceiling. If we lay that the day just passes by, I might get to too much talking. I might have to tell you something. Damn. I like me better when I'm with you. I like me better when I'm with you.
me better when I'm with you. I knew from the first time, I stayed for a long time, cause I like me better when I like me better when I'm with you.
Stay you up, stay you with me. Stay you up, stay you up, oh. Stay you up, stay you up, stay.
I like me better when I'm with you.